also want to be real clear that I'm very proud to say that we have had elected our first black president. All right? I'm sorry. Right. I'm sorry he didn't do a better job. I really wish that he would have. I do.
Kid Rock at a Romney Ryan event last year. He was one of my very first guests back in January 2011. We had a conversation. I'll never forget in a hurry. We talked politics. We drank some badass beer. And we came out with this afterwards. We'll discuss that in a moment, Mr. Rock. Anyway, he's now getting ready to go back down the road. And he's promising fans the best night ever without going broke. Joining me again is Kid Rock. How are you?
Good. Nice to see you.
So you were actually the very first interview I conducted for CNN. It wasn't the first to air, but the first one I did. And you gave that legendary promo to the bleep is Piers Morgan. I was very gratified that you introduced yourself to me by name and said, hello, Piers.
You've come a long way. Congratulations.
So look,
welcome to American pop culture.
Thank you. I feel like I've made it. Kid Rock knows who I am. I feel like I've made it. Let's get serious. I love your promotional ticket tour thing. You've got 29 concerts, American tour. Ticket prices would normally, I guess, have been between $130 and $140. You've decided to nail your mask to a flat fee of $20 and $4 a beer for 12 ounce, a dozen of beer. Why are you doing it? What do you hope to achieve?
It's gotten out of hand. The price of concerts, the price of entertainment, period. You know, whether it's a sporting event, going to the movies, buying a soda there, whatever. And what do? Obviously, a musician to play concerts. I've been very fortunate. I've always tried to keep prices what I think are fair. And I've always said I'm proud that I could walk around with my head held high and look someone in the eye knowing that I haven't taken an unhonest dollar from working there. But how can we make it better? Well, the artists come in and say, we want to get paid this much to show up, which is usually an astronomical amount. And I went with Live Nation. I said, how can we just go in, take everything, the beer, the parking, whatever the price of tickets are, and put it in a pot, split it up fairly based on the number of people that come, and they're like, you're going to have to take a pay cut. No problem. I make a lot of money. I can take a pay cut. All my friends are taking pay cuts that are in the unions, that are farming in Alabama, whatever it is. I can surely take a pay cut too, not cutting down my show or the people that work for me. I can take a pay cut.
Do you know how much this is going to cost you?
It could be from 50 to 100 grand a night, looks like. But you know, if you do the numbers, it's not going to be that much. But you know, 5,000 people show up, it's going to be a long summer. But somebody's got to try it. I'm in a position where I can.
Justin Timberlake and Jay-Z, apparently the highest ticket prices of their shows are going for about $225 each. And it's
garbage.
It's just taking family. I mean, what do you think when people
garbage? It's garbage. It's highway rock. I don't care who you are. You know, I would consider both them, you know, in the circle of friends in the business, but I don't agree with it. I know sometimes the market determines that. So what I'm going to do for that is I'm going to scout 1,000 of my own tickets. There is a market. I'm going to tell people. A lot of artists already do it. I think I've been guilty of it in the past, too. We take some of our tickets, we put them on StubHub, overcharge with what the market determines they're worth. I'm taking 1,000 of them, and I'm scalping it. So if you want to be guaranteed a ticket, because sometimes you buy it from the scalper, you get there, there's already someone in your seats. So the way to do that, hey, be transparent with people. Let them know. You know, it's $4 for a beer. My t-shirts are going to be $20. People are going to be pleasantly surprised when they come in there and they see, you know, four hot dogs and two Cokes for $20. And you can get free coffee at the end. I got Jimmy John's, you know, who's
a free coffee as well.
Free coffee on the
menu. Fantastic.
We have free subs outside in certain markets. You know, Jimmy John's agreed to do tastings over there. You know, my sponsors Harley Davidson and Jim Beam helped to keep the ticket price low to be able to advertise and things like that. So I'm just trying to go above and beyond to make it, you know, crossing my fingers so it works. The people that they're really looking for a good night of entertainment. It's not just me. The first leg of the tour is me, Cool in the Gang, and Uncle Cracker. The second leg is me, ZZ Top, and Uncle Cracker. $20. Every freaking seat. 93% of seats.
It's amazing. You're doing it predominantly, I guess, because you have sensed the economy in America, for many people, it is still very tough.
I live in Clarkson, Michigan. I have a home here in Malibu, and if I lived there full-time, I wouldn't be thinking about it. But living in a small town in Michigan, obviously, we've been hit very, very hard over the last several years, harder than I guess anybody, you know, around the Detroit area has in America, and, you know, I see it every day with my friends.
What do you think? What is the reality of America right now?
I mean, it's embarrassing. You have people who you think were middle class and have families, and one day their house is gone. And they were embarrassed to tell you or to ask you for help. That's one of the biggest things I've seen, you know, in my hometown and in where I live.
What do you make of the dysfunction in Washington where they can't seem to get any kind of budget deals done, any kind of economic plans sorted, nothing?
Oh, they're out of their freaking minds. Their people are so upset with them, and rightfully so, me included, that everything has to be so damn extreme. You know, I don't think anybody wants a bunch of pot-smoking hippies running the country, and nobody wants a bunch of crazy Bible thumpers running it either. Most of us that are rational thinkers say, hey, there's room to come together on all this stuff. You know, and everyone takes everything out of context. They bring up their own stats, which nobody knows. Everything's totally confusing. Common man, even like myself, I don't know how to pay my taxes.
Do you feel the gap between the rich and poor is just widening all the time now?
I think so. I don't think the rich should be demonized over it. Because I know a lot of rich people, obviously, at this point. I know a lot of poor people, too. You know, all over the board, but... You know, I still see a lot of the private sector people. My friends do a lot of good, especially in Detroit. You look at the big names there, they do tons of good. Millions and millions of dollars, more than the government could ever tax them. But at the same time, you have a very corrupt government there, where people are scared to help that out. And really what I think it boils down to, above everything else, is family structure. I don't care what you're talking about nowadays. You're talking about politics, you're talking about guns, any of the hot topics going on, it comes down to family. You know, and having a family. Some say that a family could be a community. You know, people that are around that help raise you, this, that, and the other. The lack of the family, you know, presence is paralyzing this country.
Let's take it a little bit. Let's come back and talk more about those hot topics. We'll talk to you about guns, gays, God, abortion, Clint Eastwood, and anything else I can think of.
See you later.
Come on.